Back, Casey. Try and make sure he can see you.
In a few minutes, our next potential predator will probably be thinking he, too, should have stayed away.
Okay, his name is Lorne, L-O-R, and he, you're Kayla. He should have condoms, pizza, bracelet, and a can.
Hey, I'm glad you could come. How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
Good.
Turns out today's his birthday. He's 37-year-old Lorne Armstrong, a construction worker. He's been chatting with a girl posing as a 13-year-old for more than a month. It's one of the longest chat logs we've ever seen. 407 pages. Using the screen name LorneA20014, he tells her how to masturbate and then asks her if she wants to see him naked. She agrees, and he turns on his webcam. He wants her to look at his penis.
Would you like to see it up close so you can get a better look at it?
I really never wanted to talk to her like that. I never wanted to be that way. I never wanted to be sexual with her.
Okay.
Why not? I never meant for that to happen.
Okay. I don't want you to say I never meant.
I never wanted to be like that with a kid.
Okay.
I've never what? Wanted to be like that. I've always cared about kids. I've never fucking wanted to be like that. I never wanted to be like that. My only answer is because someone was carrying me, because that's what it was at the time.
Okay, wait a minute.
You have no idea how low I fucking felt.
Okay.
I mean, I fucking put everything out for my family and for what I thought my was my best friend Tony. And fuck, they acted like they never gave a shit. Fuck, I lost them so fucking much because they didn't give a shit and fucking. I just wanted to know that I fucking mattered to someone.
Okay.
I know, I did wrong.
Raping someone and being there for them?
Why do you keep fucking pressuring me on this?
Lawrence, this whole thing would be easier on you if you took responsibility. Stop blaming Dateline, stop blaming NBC, and take responsibility.
Why do you keep misunderstanding me? I take responsibility for everything I said and everything I did.
Well,
you can't really say that the chat was doctors. You don't, when you say the chat
was doctors.
Yes, because I can fucking point out shit in there that was doctor. I know shit in there that was fucking doctor. I mentioned when I was in the jail and fucking looked at the door both times.
So.
And I pointed out to the guys in the fucking, in the cell with me. I know, I noticed that shit that was fucked up like.
I get lost. Come on. I was helping to do this. Oh, I hear.
You fucking cockhead.
You told me to do it.
No, it was you.
You told me to send you the picture. Do you not remember? You said, I'm gonna call your bluff. And I was like, fine. And I sent you the picture. And then you said, oh, Casey texted me, blah, blah, blah. And you shit through your ass. And then you got excited. And I kept telling you, Lauren, I sent the picture.
Oh, fucking A. Hang on, because I gotta look at what I sent to Casey. Hang on a second.
Have another beer, Lord.
Hi.
Finally.
Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Can you hear me now? Okay.
I kept going to your voicemail.
Stop calling me. I was trying to fucking clear my fucking phone so I could fucking hear your call.
Ow.
Stop calling me a stupid fuckface.
What do you want me to call you?
That's probably Emma. It's either Emma sending me a message now or it's you. I've got like three or four messages, and it's either Emma or you.
Okay. Well, I was waiting for you to
I didn't know you were trying to call me.
Okay.
I was talking to Emma at the same time, and I never expected anything from you, then all of a sudden you told me you were trying to call me.
Yeah.
And it was like all fucked up. I was trying to send you a message at the same time. And all of a sudden, I heard a fucking vibration on my phone. And all of a sudden, the thing came up that in the meeting and shit like that. And at the same time, I heard a vibration. I was like, son of a bitch, I can't do anything about it because I don't know how to work the fucking phone. to get away from that in a meeting shit.
Wow, that was a lot.
Yeah, well, it kind of fucked me up, and I was like, fuck, I don't know how to get back to it to answer the call.
Right. Well, it's all set now.
Right. Right. I love you. Don't ever fucking go a day without fucking talking to me again.
So you're telling me you love me, and then you threaten me? Don't ever.
Well, yeah, don't ever do it again, and I won't ever do it to you again. So it wasn't a threat. It was I promise I will never do it to you again. Just please don't ever do it to me again.
Well, no, I'm not promising anything.
There was no threat involved there at all. I promise I will never, ever, I will never, ever, literally not answer your call.
Just like you won't ever hang up and you won't yell at me either?
I promise those both of those things, too. I will never, ever hang up on you again, and I promise. And I will never, don't laugh at me. Yeah.
Okay.
But the other thing was that you said.
You don't have to make promises, okay?
And I will never yell at you again.
Oh,
my God. And I promise, as long as you don't start yelling at me.
I can yell at you. I'm not promising shit.
But I promise I will never, ever hang up with you again.
Yeah, okay.
It's just when I ask you for a minute so that I can take a breath and realize what's going on.
Well, you shouldn't need that, number one. And don't act like a big fucking baby.
Well,
we both need that. I don't need that.
We both need. Yeah, you do.
No,
you realize that in the future when you get frustrated with me, you realize. Just give me a
I'm
minute.
I'm frustrated with you like so every 5 minutes.
Well, you shouldn't be. I'm not hard to understand.
I've never had anybody treat me the way that you do, by the way. Like, hang up the phone, have these little hissy fits. Never, never has happened. So, what I want
you to do is
get a condom and take off your fucking pants. You're going to jerk off with me for being a bad boy.
Casey, I'm in love with you.
Okay, take off your pants. Get a condom.
I'm not taking off my pants right now. No.
What do you mean?
We're in the middle of a fucking conversation. We're in the middle of a conversation.
The conversation's done. You're making empty promises. I don't buy it.
No, the conversation is not done because we have had a rough debate.
You're
going to
start yelling.
No.
And I want you to take off your pants and jerk off.
Yeah, well, and I'm not going to do it right now.
Okay.
We've had a rugged couple of days.
My days have been fine. I'm relaxing.
Your days are?
I'm doing amazing in rehab. I got a charger that Emma sent me. She sent it like overnight, which is amazing.
So
and
you got the charger, so we don't have to worry about your phone going dead now.
Right. That is how chargers work. So my phone's going to be fine.
I didn't think that you'd get that until fucking Tuesday, because she just sent it yesterday.
No, she sent it like one day. She must have spent a lot of money.
Yesterday was Saturday, and today is Sunday.
Right. You can have same-day shipping. So I actually got it today. They handed it to me today, but it came in yesterday. And I can't charge it in front of people. It's not like I can just whip it out and just be like, oh, my phone's going to die. I have to charge it.
I know that.
Okay, well, you have to really know that instead of saying that you do and then getting pissed off if I tell you, my phone's going to die, I'm going to be away from it for a while, I need to charge it. You'd be like, who are you talking to?
I want you to explain something to me, though. Did he come to see you yesterday?
No.
You invited him to, though.
Okay, so because I invited him to means that he showed up?
I figured that... I figured that he would.
What? Okay, but he didn't.
You know I don't like him.
I know you don't.
Yeah, I think you know why I don't like him. I'm not sure that you know why, but I think you know why I don't like him.
Okay.
It's because of what he did to you. That's why I don't like him.
Okay, and you know what he didn't like?
We're not going to turn this around. We're not going to turn this around on me.
you're not going to turn it around on him.
I know what you're doing right now. Why do you keep talking about him?
Because I wanted to just talk to you tonight. I didn't want to go through your bullshit.
Well, I know, but you love me and I love you.
Every day we have to do this?
No, not every day. But it's shit that we need to talk about.
Yeah, but what I'm saying
why are you taking this so much to heart?
Really? You're going
to
say,
You're taking more to heart than I am.
You take everything to heart.
To me, this is a discussion between me and you.
Right.
It's not something I'm taking to heart. I'm in love with you. I'm not taking it to heart.
Of course you are. You do it with everything.
I'm wanting to understand why you're defending him.
I'm not saying that he's in the way.
I do want to understand that because of the stuff that he did to you.
Let me explain it then. Are you going to let me do that?
Okay.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
I'm not defending him. I know it feels like that, but that's not what I'm doing. All I'm saying, I understand that what he did to me and what he did to Nick is a problem, okay? But what I do have a problem with is for you to point at him and call him a pedophile as if he's a disgusting piece of shit when he can point the same finger at you and call you the same thing. That's what I have a problem with. So just leave it off the table. And the other thing that I have a problem with is that you inserted yourself into my own situation with him. It takes away from my healing when you take it upon yourself to say it to him. That wasn't your place.
Okay, but now you're putting me on the spot because I said that to him because I knew that about him.
That had to do with me, though.
I also know more stuff about him.
Okay, you didn't talk about that stuff. You talked about me.
I talked about Nick, too.
Yeah, and that wasn't even your story to tell. How dare you bring up Nick? He's not there to defend himself. You don't know how he feels.
You're right.
Apologize because you did wrong.
It's not my story to tell.
Right.
It's not my story to tell.
So stop telling it.
But it is for me to tell him that other people know about the bullshit that he's done.
You're completely contradicting yourself.
Casey, listen.
Lorne Armstrong, you're contradicting yourself.
Casey, what's your middle name?
I don't have one.
Casey, that does not make me feel secure. Paul was not the one that named you. He's not your biological dad.
I know that, but he changed my name.
Okay, what did he change it to?
You know that
makes me feel very uncomfortable.
Because he changed my name when I was a kid?
Because that mixes the whole story up, so it doesn't sound right.
Okay, well, I don't really give a shit. That's my story. It's my name. Believe it or not.
You need to give a shit or not.
Fucking idiot. I don't have
one. Why would you call me a fucking idiot?
Because, Lauren, do you hear yourself? I'm telling you, I don't have a middle name. People don't have middle names.
Yeah, people don't have middle names. Listen to me, Casey.
Shithead piece of
you
shit.
Know all about the fucking bullshit that I go through online.
Don't fucking care.
Don't throw bullshit out at me.
I don't fucking care. I don't give
if
a
you
shit
care about
if you don't
me, then you do care about what I think.
I don't care if you don't believe that I don't have a middle name. I'm telling you that I don't have a middle name.
Who said I don't believe?
You
did. Not me.
You're acting like
I love
like,
fucking
that doesn't
say
make
that
me feel comfortable. That doesn't make me feel comfortable.
Well, you don't want to listen to why it doesn't make me feel comfortable.
I don't care. Instead,
you
I'm
want
not
to
caught
assume
up in your
shit.
Internet bullshit. I'm not caught up in that.
Then why wouldn't you listen to me?
Because what you're saying is completely fucking stupid. I don't care about your internet bullshit.
If I don't tell you what is on my mind, then I would be completely stupid.
Because I don't have a middle name.
Casey, stop.
Lorne, stop.
If I do not tell you what is on my mind, and I would be completely stupid.
Tell me what's on your mind. Tell me what's on your mind. Go.
Because I need to know. I need to hear everything that you fucking say. I need to analyze everything that you say so that I know for a fact that you're you and you're real. I don't have a fucking choice, okay? I don't yell at you right now. I want to understand.
Okay.
That's what I want to do, is I want to understand everything.
Okay.
I have got to understand everything. If I don't, I'm screwing myself.
Okay.
I want to believe everything you're fucking telling me because I'm already in love with you.
Okay.
I pray to God that everything you're telling me is true.
Okay.
That is all I can do right now is pray to God until you and I are face to face.
Okay.
I don't have a choice. I'm on probation. I don't have a choice.
Okay. Get on those knees, Lauren, and pray away. Because what I'm telling you,
if you don't have a middle name, I know people that don't have, do not have middle names.
Great.
So if you don't have a middle name, then I'm going to believe you.
Thank you.
I just want you to be honest with me.
That was really painful.
What was painful?
Going through all that.
Me telling you. Well, it was painful because you finally let me talk.
Because you yelled at me again.
I was, don't pull that on me.
Why don't you pull
way
your little pecker
for you to be,
jerk off.
The only way for you to hear me was for me to be able to yell.
Okay. I want to hear you coming. That's what I want.
That's what you want, but that's not going to happen right now.
Why? Because you can't do it?
You'll be up more pro. Nope. Can't do it right now. That's what you want to hear? Can't do it right now.
We have
more pressing issues.
What?
Like the last couple of days. Casey, this shit doesn't go away.
What?
Why do you think this shit goes away?
What shit?
The shit that brought us to this stuff.
What? What did I do? What's your problem?
Well, did he come to see you?
No, he didn't come to see me.
Why not?
I don't know. He didn't. We didn't make plans. We just threw it out there. We didn't make a plan to.
Okay, well, you talked to him all night long.
No, I didn't talk to him all night
long.
Talk
to him. Huh?
We didn't talk all night long. I had to go to bed at some point.
You told me you were going to talk to him all night because you didn't want to talk to me.
No, I didn't want to talk to you. You're absolutely right about that. But I didn't talk to him all night.
He didn't get you another phone?
No.
Why not?
Why would he?
Because he doesn't have the money?
What the fuck are you talking about, Lorne? Come on, man. Get a fucking grip.
I'm being an asshole for
a
minute.
Because
I reserve the right when it comes to him.
Lorne, seriously, this is really exhausting and stupid. I'm not lying to you. I'm not lying to you. Either you're going to believe it or you're not. I mean, because I'm not going to talk about this all night. So it's done.
Why do you keep saying it's done? Why is it the final word that you say is done?
Right. Done. Over. Finished.
Why is it the final word that you say is done?
Because
when you say it's
what
done,
is the point in continuing? You don't believe
me. You
say
it's completely done.
You don't believe me, that's why. Why do we have to keep going? There's no point.
Because of the fact that I don't... Because that's unfucking believable. Because if it was you in that fucking position, you would say, no, it's not fucking done.
Okay, so then don't believe it. I really don't know what to tell
you.
So
anybody that would tell you that it was done, you would say, no, it's not done. I want you to be honest with me, Casey. I will never fucking lie to you. And I promise you that. I will never, ever fucking lie to you at all. Ever.
Okay, except for Kate.
So don't do it to me.
That was your one time, right?
Huh?
Kate, do you remember her? That was your one time when you lied?
You can bring Kate up all you want.
Yeah, okay, I will.
That happened?
About that then.
But I will never ever fight. I will never ever lie to you again.
Okay,
you and I weren't as close as what we are now. You and I were not as close as what we are now. I will never ever fucking lie to you again.
You were telling me that you loved me back then. That you were so in love with me.
Now it's quite a different story.
Why is it different now?
Now it's quite a different story because
you throw love around. I'm completely in love with you.
After a day of fucking not being with you, I'm fucked up.
You don't make any sense.
After 2 days of not being with you, I'm really fucked up. I've been 2 days without you.
You were probably talking to Elizabeth.
Who?
Elizabeth. Your buddy Elizabeth.
No, I wasn't talking to Elizabeth.
Were you flirting with her?
Elizabeth didn't even come into my fucking mind. The only thing that was in my fucking mind is, why the fuck would she be talking to Finn after the fucking crap that he did to her?
Okay, but the thing is,
why would she fucking choose him over me? Why would she put me down like she did? None of that fucking made sense to me.
Okay.
She doesn't want my car. I got a fucking 90-degree cock now, and before it was so fucking good. What the fuck?
That was funny.
It was funny. It was funny to you. It didn't make sense to me.
Well, do you want me to call Emma right now and see what she has to say?
Yep.
You want me to call her right now?
Yes, ma'am, I do. And I love you, PC Armstrong. Let me hear you say that. I know. What's your name?
Hang on 1 second. I'm going to call right now.
What's your name?
My name's Casey.
Casey, what's your last name?
Hey.
Oh, hey. You're on the phone with Lorne?
Yeah, and Casey, too.
Oh, hi. Hi, Casey. Nice to kind of meet you.
Nice to meet you, too. Well, I just wanted to call because Lorne and I were having a really calm and rational discussion. And
oh, cool.
I had asked if he was talking to you, Elizabeth, and he said no. So I said, do you want me to call Emma? And he said, yeah. So that's what I did. And here you are. So that even makes it better.
Well, like, talking to him, how? Huh?
Well, talking to him at all.
Like since we...
She already knows about the time that I've talked to Elizabeth. I've already told her.
It was about a week ago, week and a half ago, maybe. But Casey, nothing happened, and I swear, when, you know, I told him not to break up with you, and, you know, I told him that, you know, to see where things go. So don't even worry. I mean, cause you know, I know that like you guys were on the rocks then and, I didn't want anything. You know, I didn't want him to leave you for me. I wanted you guys to work things out.
Oh, were you guys talking about
Elizabeth has actually been a friend to me like Emma has in that matter because she helps me think about things.
Yeah, and I totally have a lot of respect for you, and, you know, I was not going to let him break up with you and get back with me, you know, I just wanted you guys to work things out.
He wanted to get back with you?
I mean, but it's not going to happen, like, because you guys are together.
No, it's not. He wanted to get back with her. It's that he wanted somebody to talk to because you wouldn't talk to me.
Did I say the wrong thing? Oh my gosh. Did I say the wrong thing?
Bye.
Like, no, you didn't say the wrong thing.
Oh, God. Oh, okay. Bye, guys.
Hello.
Hi.
Hi.
Told you I'm not hiding anything from you.
She just said you were trying to get back with her.
No.
Yeah. It's okay, Lorne.
Well,
if that's what you wanted, that's
it's
okay.
It's not okay. The way you're thinking is not okay.
Yeah, but you were just...
You would not talk to me. And I was very confused.
And then, so you wanted to get back with her. You were thinking about it, though.
I was thinking about it because you weren't talking to me.
Okay, that's all that I needed to know. You were going to get back
to
her.
And I was very confused.
And she said
no. I was very confused about what was going on.
So, but then you would jump to somebody else?
No, I didn't jump to anybody else. Why do you think I called Elizabeth?
She said no.
I know Elizabeth.
Right. She just said that you were thinking about getting back together with her, and she said no.
She talks to me, Casey. She talks to me, Casey.
Don't talk to me like that.
I'm not talking to you like that.
Fucking
I'm trying to tell you. She talks to me. She talks to me so she helps me think about things. And she talks to me about things, and she helps me think things through.
Yeah, but she was talking about...
I don't talk to Elizabeth like I do Emma.
...with her, and she said no. You were thinking about getting back together with her because I wasn't talking to you or having a hard time, whatever. And you were just going to jump right over. But she said no.
I had thought about. I'm being completely honest with you.
Okay, be completely honest.
I thought about Elizabeth coming up to meet me.
Mm-hmm. Just like Kate.
Because you weren't talking to me, and I didn't think you were going to talk to me again. Because you and I were having a very difficult talk.
Right.
And I told Elizabeth, I said, if you want to come up to meeting, now would be the time.
Why would that be the time? I mean, if she's going to be friends with you, then she can come meet you all the time. Was there something sexual going on?
I don't know. Because she told me that, you know, it's either going to be me or Casey. If I'm going to put my heart in it, then I'll come up to meet you, but... If I can't put all my heart into it, then I don't want to come up to them. And I couldn't let that happen because I didn't want all her heart into it because I knew I wanted you.
Interesting. Did you guys have phone sex?
No. I've never had phone sex with her.
Why not?
Because she tried to have phone sex with me once. We were together 10 months, we never had fucking phone sex. After we were done, she tried to have phone sex with me, and I didn't want to have phone sex with her. Because I was with you. I told her, don't do that. And she did that, and I would hang up on her. And she stopped.
Okay.
She's actually been very respectable. If I ever talked to her on the phone alone again, no.
What do you mean, no? Can't be trusted?
Well, because after I talked to her that last time, last week, since then, I had a friend go on the computer, and I saw a conversation that was between me and her from 1:14:18 and 1:16:18. They're recording, and they're on the internet. I will never talk to her on the phone again, alone again. That was the first time I ever heard it.
Oh.
That was the first time that I ever see her on the internet. Because of that, I will never talk to her on the phone alone again.
How are you seeing it? You don't have the computer.
Because I have a friend that can get on the computer. I have a brother that can get on the computer. I have a mother that can get on the computer. I have an aunt that can get on the computer. I have so many fucking people around me that can get on the computer and look at anything I want to fucking see.
So you just sit there and look yourself up? That's kind of funny.
Well, it's kind of all I have to do is punch in Lorne Armstrong and geez,
but why
look
do
at
you
the
do
fucking
that?
Magic that happens.
Why do you do that?
Because I need to know what is going on the computer about me.
There's nothing going on about you.
I have to know.
Obviously.
I don't have a choice. I don't have a choice. My girlfriend told me.
What the fuck am I going to Google you
Emma
for?
Tells me. Emma tells me. Why
good.
Would you,
you,
why would you want to Google
there.
Me?
And torture your mother, and your poor aunt, and your friends. Sit there. How about if you Google Lorne Armstrong so we can sit there and listen to my calls? Is that kind of what happens?
Why would you Google me? So that I know what's going on about me. Because there are some things that I have to turn into the authorities.
Well, they can look it up for you. If they're so concerned about it, they can look it up for you.
That's why Animal Watch is a computer for me.
Okay, then you don't need me to do it.
Well, but it helps when you do it.
In case I'm in the midst of it. It just makes you feel better. But I'm not doing it.
Knowing that people love me and are looking out for me, damn straight, that makes me feel better.
I don't need to sit there and Google you. I don't need to do things so that your little brain can be like, oh, she loves me.
Why? You were doing it. She was doing it before when I didn't even know. Just put my yard sale online and I didn't even know about it. Which was extremely sweet.
I know. It was.
It was fucking adorable.
Yeah. Cutest thing ever.
It was really adorable. And I wish I was a normal person so that I was fucking... That was fucking... I had to fucking smile when that happened. When I found out about that. I love you, Casey. I don't give a fuck what happens. Whatever fucking wreck time you have, whatever argument we get into about anything, whatever wreck time you fucking have, if you don't have your fucking cell phone, and you're able to use the phone at wreck time to call me, the fucking time is precious to me. I love you, and I don't know what word you don't understand about that.
What do you mean, but I don't understand? I know, I understand that it's special. But you try to, like, possess it. Like, if you don't, then who are you talking to?
I don't try to possess it.
You do. You try to possess everything. It's really funny.
I know what you're talking about.
Okay, well...
I very much know what you're talking about.
What I want you to do is jerk off for me, you creepy, perverted, bald-headed, inconsiderate cocksucker. That 90-degree dick, and jerk it.
It's not going to happen tonight. It's not going to happen.
Lame.
Not right now.
Fucking lame.
Yeah, I know.
Do you want me to make a guy's voice so that you can come for it?
Well, that'd be good.
Oh, okay.
No.
I thought you were
going to
say yes.
It's not going to happen right now. I'm telling you, it's not going to happen right now because of all the crap we've been through in the last few weeks.
Do you need some boner pills?
Look at the things that you said to me. You put me down when he was on the phone, and then you defend him.
I wasn't defending him. I told you already at the beginning that I wasn't defending him. I never said that he was a great guy. I am saying that those things that you said to him and the fingers that you are pointing at him are the same ones that everyone is pointing at you. So, and the other thing that I was upset about was that you were telling him that you knew about my story and you had no business to do that. You did it because you wanted to try to have...
You invited him to see you.
Shut your mouth this time. I was talking.
You don't let me talk.
I was talking. Don't fucking talk over me, shithead.
Yes, ma'am.
I was saying that I didn't want you to go and talk to him about my story. That was none of your business. You tried to make it your business so that you could have some kind of a power trip over him. That's not fair. You used that. And you used Nick, too. If you want to talk about him, about whatever your bullshit is, then you can do that, but you leave everyone else out of it. You know what that is? That's hashtag Lorne logic right there.
Well, I think I'm not here. I'm still listening to you.
Okay, good. I appreciate that.
You just love shit in my ear, don't you?
I do. It's so fun.
Wait till you embarrass him.
So I can shit right in your face.
Wait till you
can't wait.
Wait until you're in person until you wake up.
Wake up. Am I gonna be tied up and thrown into a pit in your backyard?
Wait until you wake up in bed with me. I'm going to eat something the night before to make sure that when you wake up, my ass is right in your face and I'm going to fart.
I'll bite your balls.
I'll enjoy it.
Because
it's your mouth or my ball. Unless you bite. Unless you bite hard.
That's what I said.
I might have to think of a different plan.
That's a good idea.
Yeah, I didn't invite you. Didn't think about that one.
Okay.
I gotta think of a different plan.
Okay.
Now help me understand why, after what that piece of shit did to you, why would you invite him to go see you?
I wanted to piss you off.
Why?
Because it's funny. I was so pissed off at you that I didn't care, and I was just going to say anything. And that's what I said, because I knew that you would completely fly off the fucking handle. And I love it. Makes my nipples
hard. Do you love me? Do you love me?
I want to.
Do you, Casey? Yes or no?
You don't make yourself lovable at all. You make yourself really fucking annoying. You make yourself a crybaby. You make yourself a cockhead. All those things.
If I need to be, I can be the biggest asshole you ever see.
I know. But guess what? You're not a bigger asshole.
Do you love me? I want to know if you love me.
Stop being a crybaby little bitch. I'm not going to say shit to you.
Well,
let me, if I feel
being
a fucking
that drama queen.
You stop being a
drama
queen.
Stop being a drama queen.
You're the biggest fucking queen here.
You're a drama queen.
No, I'm not. You are.
You literally are.
Tell me you love me. Tell me you love
Casey.
Me. Like you're
Casey.
Juliet
get
on
real.
The balcony.
You literally are a drama queen.
Where art thou?
You literally are a drama queen. You are not happy unless drama is going on around you.
I've been Why happy. I am happy all the time.
If there's drama...
I don't even create drama. That's the thing.
No, you create a lot. You create drama.
You
literally create drama.
You do. Is that your middle name?
You don't create... how are you going to tell me that you do not create drama when the reason you're in rehab right now is because of the court
it's
order.
Because I have an
Because
addiction
of the fact
problem.
Of what you did... Because of what you did at Emma's.
It's because I have an addiction problem. If they thought that I was dangerous, they would put me in prison.
Casey, having an addiction problem... does not have anything to do with not having an $800 phone.
So?
Yeah, I know about it.
Lauren, are you hard yet?
That is not... Listen. I'm not saying that to put you down in any way. Don't
You are,
that.
Though. You're trying to.
No, I'm not trying to. I don't want you thinking that.
Do you think me going after Emma for an $800 phone sounds like a logical thing? Do you think that maybe that there's a problem there? Like, maybe I was high
between you and Emma?
Maybe I was, you know, not very well, and so they decided to put me in rehab instead of real criminal to go to prison. Because they figured they could fix me, and that I need to get some help.
So Emma was lying to me?
Lying about what?
About it being because of an $800 phone. There's more to the story than
well,
what.
Yeah, that's why I got in trouble.
So, how much of the story is being lied to me?
She said that she wouldn't get me an $800 phone. That's the phone that I wanted. Okay, I'm sick of using this one. She said no. And I got pissed off about it. You don't even listen.
Why? Because
you're retarded.
Because I'm listening to you.
Okay.
I didn't even say anything to you. I told me I wasn't listening. I'm listening to you.
Okay. My little retard.
No. You don't know if I can think that shit. You're the one that's putting that shit in your head. Nobody else.
That you're retarded?
Yeah, from that too.
Okay.
As long as you love me, I don't give a fuck.
Okay. Well, stop, you know, stop with the whole, like, which part is lying, which part's not lying, either believe it or not.
I have to, because look at what you two are doing.
What we're doing? What are we doing?
Yeah. Look at what you two are doing. I gotta fucking sort out the story, so don't tell me, don't try to fucking sort shit out. Because that's kind of human nature. When something don't sound right somebody, they sort it and try to sort the shit out.
I mean, I was explaining something to you, and then you just go off about how, well, how much of it's not true? How much is Emma lying?
Yeah, yeah,
telling just, the truth? Like, what the fuck? Why do you talk to people that you don't trust?
I asked you. There was nothing behind it.
Why would you ask? Obviously, there is something behind it, because you're not going to ask something if there's nothing. There's no reason for it.
Because you're my girlfriend. I expected you to be honest with me.
Okay, so then expect it and understand that that's true.
Okay, then just tell me. Listen.
I just told you.
Just tell me. Don't make a fucking scene on the whole thing.
You're a scene.
I don't know. You like my scene? Oh, no, you don't. Because my scene is 90 degrees.
Yeah, it is. Is it ready yet?
No.
Why?
No. Because we spent 2 days away from each other.
Can you sing to me that?
Because we spent 2 days away from each other, and we're going to talk.
Oh, this is so boring.
That is constant fucking sexual bullshit when we need to fucking get to know each other.
We're getting around, going around in this fucking circle.
The answers that need to be fucking taken here.
Answers need to be taken? You don't make any sense.
Yeah, that doesn't make sense. All right, there's answers that need to be answered. Yeah.
Okay.
Don't treat me like an asshole. I'm fucking smart. What do you believe in?
That is funny. Oh, that's a funny.
I don't know how much of an asshole you seem to that you think I am.
A huge one. A big, smelly one with, like, 500 hemorrhoids.
But guess what? I'm your asshole. I'm your asshole.
Okay.
And there are times when you have to fucking cough up. And there are questions that need to be answered.
I just want you to sing for me.
Okay, but I just want you to answer questions for me.
Like what?
Okay. When was it that you met Emma?
What? When?
When did you... Yeah. And I want honest answers.
Well, when are you... What are you talking about? Which time?
I want to... the very, very, very first time. I want very honest answers because Ramona is in the position that she's in now because she wasn't honest with me.
Okay, well, I'm actually not going to sit here and be interrogated. So you can fuck off.
I'm not going to interrogate you.
Well, you're trying to.
I am not going to interrogate you.
You're trying to compare me to Elizabeth.
Casey.
Lauren.
Listen to what I'm saying. I'm not going to interrogate you. The very first time that you and I talked, you wanted me to get rid of Emma. So it's
yeah,
not like I'm really fucking threatened by shit.
Okay, then why are we going through this?
Well, because I kind of have to.
You don't have to. Don't trust me then. I don't give a shit. What the fuck?
No, I'm trusting you. I'm trusting you.
Okay, so we're not going to do this.
You know I have reasons to do this.
It's usually when you're drunk, she
you
said.
You should not have a problem.
You said that you don't drink.
You should not have a problem with any question that I asked
like
you.
It kind of sounds like it, because you're slurring your speech.
Okay, ask me any question.
Any
ask me any question. I will answer your question.
Did you drink tonight?
You see how much of a problem I have answering it.
Did you drink tonight? Alcohol.
Now, when I answer your questions, you should not have any problem at all answering any questions. Casey, don't talk over me.
Don't talk over me.
You should not have any problem answering any question that I have, because I'm answering any question that you have. Okay,
so go ahead and answer. Did you drink alcohol today?
Nope.
That's such a lie.
How can you say a lie? I'm telling you no.
You sound like you have marbles in your mouth.
Huh?
Did you drink today? Because you really sound like it. I'm not just making
that up. No, I have not drank at all today.
I mean, the stuff that you're saying doesn't make sense. Like, your sentences don't make sense. You sound like you're slurring. So when you go to Tony, do you drink when you hang out with, like, Tony and your other buddies?
I didn't go to Tony's today.
Okay. What about when you go there? What about this whole entire time?
I don't drink every time I go there.
Okay, maybe not every time. I don't drink every time I go to Tony's. Talking?
Huh?
Okay, so maybe not every single time. But do you drink when you go there? That's what I'm asking, since we've been talking.
Sometimes when I go to Tony's, sometimes I do have a beer or two.
Okay, so every single time you've lied then. Every time I've asked you, you lied. Yes.
No.
You said you don't drink anymore. You said you don't drink anymore at all because it was easier for you to deal with probation.
Well, yeah, that's true because of what I had to do. I haven't drank with Tony since what I had to do. It doesn't matter.
Yeah, you've been lying. So what is it? How many beers do you normally have?
I'm not answering that question.
Oh, because before you said it, you don't have a problem answering my questions. And Casey. I shouldn't have a problem answering yours.
Casey?
You're a liar. You said ask you anything. You meet me in person. I don't need to ask you this in person.
When you're face to face with me, Casey,
liar.
I will answer any question that you have.
Okay, so you can tell me that you've been lying then.
Get face to face with me and prove to me that you're not like fucking Ramona.
What do you mean, like Ramona? You're talking about her like she is disgusting, but yet you wanted her to come up and see you. You were ready to get back with her.
Yeah.
And now you're like Ramona. If she's so horrible, then why would you even think about that?
She still was a good person to talk to him. Right until last week, I decided it might be.
Why would you want to talk to her if she did something?
So last week, I decided she was not a person that I wanted to talk to because after I found out the fucking conversation that her and I had on the 14th and the 16th was on the internet. So I decided I'm not going to talk to her anymore because of that. Emma has proved to me that she's safe to talk to because she's not putting me on the internet. Am I going to go after Ramona and Sewer? Probably not, because I do have the fucking thing of somebody might have hacked into her. But can I sue her? Yeah, I can.
Stop trying to sue everybody, Lorne.
Am I sue happy? No, I'm not sue happy.
Yeah, well, you suck at suing because you couldn't even
sue NBC. Don't sue NBC, you're fucking right I do.
For what? Because they called you
out? If you want to start sticking up for fucking NBC, go ahead.
Okay,
I guarantee I'm going to get pissed off about it.
I'm going to get pissed, and then I'm going to hang up, and then I'm going to wait for you to call me back.
And I still haven't heard you fucking answer any questions from me.
When we're in person, face-to-face, then I will answer questions.
Good. So there'll be no more questions.
No questions.
Until we're face-to-face.
No more questions. Now take off your pants. Take that condom that you probably used before and rinse
it. No, I'm not taking off my fucking pants right now.
Jerk off.
You'll be fucking kidding me.
Because you're a jerk off. So do it.
Well, fucking drop your fucking dress.
No.
Put the dress up over here, throw it over. Throw your dress right off.
I'm not even turned on.
Why not? Good, lift your fucking dress up, pull your panties down, fucking stick your fingers in your pussy. Let me hear it. Why not? I know.
Tiny bitches, don't turn me on. Crybaby, little boy.
Exactly.
People who point the finger at other people trying to make it like the fucking shit they do is everyone else's fault. Don't turn me on.
why would you invite him to go see you?
Because it's funny, because I knew you would fucking get so pissed off at it, and I hated you at that moment.
See, you did it for a reaction out of me.
Yeah, and I got
it. Why would you do that?
Because it's funny.
It cost us about 2 days of talking to each other. It was worth it. Spend time together.
It was worth it. I hated you.
You hated me.
Mm-hmm.
Do you really realize how that sounds?
It sounds like I said I hated you.
What reason did you have to hate me?
You took something that happened to me as a child that was really traumatic, and you threw it in his face. Because you wanted to have some stupid-ass power trip over him, but you sacrificed me instead. So I don't give a fuck about your feelings. And yeah, I did hate you. So I will do whatever I can to make you feel like shit. You were being an asshole. So I treated you like one.
Do you really have any plans coming out to meet me?
After what I just said to you, that's what you come up with? You can't even apologize?
No, because it's not done. That conversation is not done. I wanted to know.
You can't even apologize for bringing that up? For dragging that out?
I'm not.
Something that happened to me and Nick, you drag it out and you try to throw it in his face? You can't apologize for that.
Why are you trying to make me feel guilty? Why are you trying to make me feel guilty?
Because you're a pile of shit. You're a pile of shit, Lorne. I want you to feel like a stupid fuckface that you are. I mean, I am listening. I can hear myself.
Keep talking. Obviously, I'm going to get the brunt of what we did.
You're getting the brunt of what you did. Isn't that fucking cunning, idiot? You can't even follow what I'm saying.
Yeah, that's cunning and I'm coming. Remember that fucking saying?
I do. That was good.
Oh, yeah. That was real fucking special, wasn't it?
One of my gems.
That was a real fucking special moment.
I loved it. Thank you for reminding me.
I'm glad you're coming to somebody that wasn't me.
You know, you're the type of guy who would go to AA and then tell everybody outside the meeting what's going on.
Are you serious? Are you serious? Yeah. You're going to fucking talk about? Are you seriously going to fucking say how good other guys are to me?
No, I'm telling you what a shithead you are. I'm not talking about other guys. I'm saying you're the type of person who would do that. That's what you did.
I'm going to
tell everybody I can.
I am.
Because you act like it.
You
act like it and you don't even apologize. You don't even see what you do. It's so fucked up. This is why I can't tell you everything. I don't care if you don't like it. You can't talk about it with other people.
Stop talking, Casey. You're not letting me get a word in.
You're such a bitch. Go ahead. Tell me your bitchy little words. That aren't going to make sense anyway.
There's only words every other fucking guy has done to you. Are you going to blame it all on me?
I'm blaming you
for what
you do.
You're blaming me.
I'm blaming you for what
you
do.
No, you're blaming me.
I'm blaming you.
You're blaming me for
what you do.
This is not the first time that you blame me for what they did.
Lauren.
You lashed out at me several different times.
Listen.
For what they did.
I'm blaming you for what you do. You talking about what happened to me to other people and to what happened to Nick to other people has something to do with you. That's what you're doing, and that's what I'm pissed off about. How I feel about any other the people who have fucked me over has nothing to do with you.
Why the fuck would you invite that cocksucker to come see you at
all?
Do I
have to say it for the third time?
Yeah. Yes.
Okay.
Say it.
All right. Okay. I wanted to say it because I knew that it was going to piss you the fuck off, and I loved it. He wasn't coming here. We didn't make plans. There wasn't a thing.
Jesus
But
Christ.
You take that bait, and you run with it, and it's funny as fuck, and I hope it really
runs
fucking
So in other words, you're playing with me.
I did. It was funny.
You're playing with me. How much are you playing with me, Casey? How much are you playing with me?
I played with you yesterday.
You didn't play with me yesterday because you didn't even talk to me yesterday. I don't know who the fuck you were talking to. We didn't even talk yesterday.
I don't keep track.
Remember?
Honestly, I really don't care.
No, I don't know who was you talking to yesterday, but it wasn't
who
me.
Who are you talking to? Same thing. Every fucking day.
Well, who'd you talk to?
It's none of your business, well, whatever I do.
Be honest with me. Be honest with me, Casey. Who'd you talk to?
Your mom. Your mom. Talk to your mom.
You're knowing you weren't going to be honest with me.
Good, and you?
No, this is not a fucking good and you moment.
It is.
It's a moment that tells me that you're not being honest with me.
Good. Okay.
Who'd you talk to yesterday?
None of your fucking business, fuckface.
Why?
Why? Because it's none of your business.
Was it the Marine? Was it the Marine?
Nope.
Was it Paul?
No.
Was it the janitor? Did you see a pattern?
I told you it was your mom.
That word pattern, like, kind of stood for it, didn't it?
No.
Oh, I kind of think it would.
Well, it doesn't.
You sure like to mention that word pattern to me. Well, you don't like it when I mention it to you, do you?
Lauren, I don't care, really.
You have a lot of them, too. You have a lot of them, too, Casey.
Take off your pants.
The only pattern that I'm waiting for is when you're going to fucking be honest with me and be straight with me and let me know that you actually love me and not every other guy on the fucking earth.
Okay.
Okay, call me, tell me, and I promise you that I will not say a word. I will put my phone on you.
No. You don't keep promises.
Why not? I will keep promises to you.
No.
I just don't want you fucking with me.
I'm not fucking with you, but honestly, the only one who can believe that is you. If you don't believe it, then you don't. There's nothing that I can do.
There's nothing to hold you back. I promise you, I will put my phone on you.
I don't know. I don't really believe you.
No, believe me. I will put my phone on you. I won't disappoint you. My goal in life has become to not disappoint you. I am trying everything I can to follow through with my promises to you. I just want you to keep every promise that you make to me for real. I don't want there to be some fucking fake-ass anything in that bullshit. I want you and me for real.
I already told you that I'm not caught up in whatever internet bullshit there is for you. I'm not interested.
That's the only reason that is the only reason that I have kept faith in you.
You don't have any faith in me.
I believe you. The biggest thing that has kept me keeping faith in you is because from the beginning, you told me you wanted Emma out of our lives.
Okay, well, if you want to be really dramatic, hold on. And,
Let's see here. You love Emma.
Hang on.
So you know why I want in our lives. She's my best friend. She doesn't want anything more.
Hang on one second. I'm going to call someone. Don't talk. Hang on.
Do I need to put my phone on mute or not?
Yes, mute now. Right now.
Hang on. Let me figure it. Okay, I found the mute button. Okay, I'm going to put my phone on mute right now, okay?
Okay. Yes, hurry up.
Hello? Hey, Casey.
Hi. How are you?
Good.
I'm good. I was just talking to Lauren, and he's getting me really pissed off, so I wanted to call you because you're always so good to me.
All right. You know, what's going on?
I just want to know what's happening, you know?
Nothing.
What are you wearing?
He's getting ready for bed.
I'm going to get ready for bed, too.
Really?
Mm-hmm. I'm in the rec area right now, so I can't just take off my clothes like I normally would, but...
What do you normally wear?
You can. Usually nothing.
Wow.
It's pretty good, right? Yeah. So, Emma actually showed me a picture of what you have going on there.
She did?
Yeah. And it's really, really impressive. So I was kind of wondering if maybe you were hard right now. What I was talking to Lauren, and he can't perform, so I was hoping maybe you could.
Oh, really? What about Emma and Lauren? I mean,
they don't have to know if you don't tell them.
Can you keep a secret?
I can. I won't tell if you don't.
My lips are sealed for now.
Thinking about that cock of yours thick as a telephone book.
Oh.
You sound like you're getting close. Oh, keep doing it. Imagine me riding on top of you.
Oh. All right, Dan. That's enough.
Wait, what the fuck?
Oh, shit.
What the fuck? What? Casey, what the fuck?
I forgot.
What the fuck did you just do?
I didn't...
Lorne, I swear it wasn't nothing. Lorne. Buddy.
Oh, shit. He's going to be so pissed off.
Lorne, talk to me. We got to fix this, buddy.
What?
What? Lorne.
You fucking tell me how that was fucking impressive.
I thought it was pretty impressive.
Really?
Yeah.
Emma's fucking boyfriend. Are you fucking serious? Why did you pick Emma's fucking boyfriend?
I like Dan. He's a good guy. Emma's not gonna care.
Call him. Call him right now. I want to talk to him and tell him. This is not going to Emma.
You want me to call Dan
this
back?
This is not going back to Emma. Call him and tell him. Call him right now. So I can tell him this is not going back to Emma.
All right, hang on. Let me see if he's going to answer, okay? Hang on.
Hello?
Hey, Dan.
Hey, Casey. Come
Listen,
on.
I'm really sorry. Okay, first I need to tell you that Lauren's on the phone.
Lorne, listen, buddy. Buddy, hey.
Dan, shut up and relax. Okay. This is not going back to Emma.
Please, don't tell Emma.
I am not gonna, she's not gonna be fucking hurt in this fucking way. If Casey ever fucking does this to you again, I wanna fucking know about it.
Lorne, you gotta believe me, Casey lured me. She lured me.
How many times has Casey done this? Dan?
No, dude, I swear to God, Lorne, it was the first time. I don't know what the fuck just happened.
I'm drinking. I don't fucking believe that. I don't fucking believe it.
Lorne, I'm a little...
This is not the first time.
No,
You're fucking be honest with me, and I'm going to tell Emma about it.
No, listen, Lorne, please.
How many times has Casey done it?
No, listen, I've been drinking...
How many times has Casey done it?
Lorne, this one time, Lorne...
Give me a number, Dan.
One... Listen, Lorne, I've been drinking vodka and cranberry.
Well, no. She's done it more than fucking once, and I know that.
No, don't tell Emma, please. Please, Lorne.
Casey, how many times have you done it?
That was the first time. He's telling the truth.
Don't fucking lie to me, Casey. You know I'm not stupid.
I'm going to get my fucking ass kicked now.
How many fucking times? You both were way too fucking comfortable for it to be the first time.
I was comfortable.
How many times has it happened? How many times has it happened?
Just that once.
How many fucking times?
Just that once. See what I mean, Dan? See how he is?
Lorne, you're my friend.
You see how I am, Casey? I want fucking honesty. I want loyalty. You can't fucking do that, even with my best friend. There's such a fucking good friend to you.
Are you fucking kidding me?
Lorne.
You don't fucking love Emma. You fucking around on her boyfriend. And you're fucking around on your boyfriend.
So, Dan, just so that you know, he's probably going to hang up right now.
No, Lorne, we can fix this. We boys, right? We boys. Come on, man. You know how it is. We boys. Come on, we sang together, man. I was lured. I was set up. Lorne. Come on.
Come on, Lorne.
Don't fucking tell me it was the first guardian time.
It was.
Stop fucking lying to me.
It was.
Don't fuck it. You fucking lie to me, I'm gonna hang up.
I just said that it was. What the fuck,
How many fucking times?
I
already know you called Dan before. I know you called in before several times.
Lorne, listen. The only time... Lorne, listen, dude.
Wait a minute, Ed. Hang on a second. Casey has your phone number. I want your phone number. What's your phone number, Dan?
You have my phone number.
I want it. I don't have your phone number. I want your phone number. Tell me what it is, Dan.
Why do you want my phone number?
I want your phone number. Casey has it. There's no fucking reason for you not to give me your phone number. What's your phone number?
I give it to you.
I don't care.
You should.
What's your phone number, Dan? What's your fucking phone number, Dan?
God, these vodka and cranberries are so strong tonight.
What is it, Dan?
Lorne, listen, we can work this out. We boys.
You want to fuck with me? Bye. You going to say something? What are you going to say, Casey? Don't fucking lie to me. Because I know you've been lying the whole fucking time now.
No, I haven't.
That was about the dumbest fucking move you could ever make.
What did I do?
Oh, geez. Like you really have to fucking think about it.
I'm sorry.
I cannot believe you fucking did that.
I'm sorry.
I cannot fucking believe you fucking did that. How many times have you done that? And don't tell me once.
I told
you're
you
You're fucking
why.
Lying your ass off. And why is it that Dan can't, that you can have Dan's number, but Dan won't give me his number?
He said that he...
Tell me why that is.
You. He said that he already gave you.
No, he number. Did not. No, he did not. And if he did, then it's all right for you to give me his number. What is it?
No, I'm not giving you his number. He can give it to you himself.
He told you that he already gave me his number.
Right, so that what I don't it? Need to give it to you. I'm not, and just in case he didn't, I'm not
yeah,
giving it to
you.
Yeah,
that's what I thought. Constantly fucking hiding shit.
No, I'm not giving somebody else his
phone
number.
Constantly fucking hiding shit. And you're not. Supposed to be my girlfriend? There's right. Nothing but a pile of fucking lies coming out tonight, isn't there?
Out of your mouth.
Out of your fucking mouth. You're the one that did it.
He said that he texted you, so why don't you check your fucking phone, you idiot?
Yeah, well, are you even Casey?
Yes.
How do I know? Why don't you send me a video of you? Make sure that
with
I
what?
Know who I'm talking to.
With what? I said I was going to
send me
you.
Okay, well, why don't you send me a video of you saying, hi, Lorne.
Oh, okay.
I am
patient. Let me go to.
Why? I don't have a problem doing that.
Let me go.
I don't have any problem doing that.
Shut your fucking idiot mouth. I said.
No, I don't fucking think so. I don't fucking think so.
I'm not going to.
I am not shutting my fucking idiot mouth.
You should.
I am not shutting my fucking idiot mouth when I have spent the last couple months going by your word from a sign. In front of what is supposed to be your picture.
It is my picture.
When it came to realize that anybody could have fucking made a picture and put a sign in front of it saying, hi, Lorne.
I don't know how to do any of that.
Oh, no. Of course you wouldn't have.
No, I don't.
Of course not.
I don't.
Yeah, I know you're a smart woman.
I don't know how to do that.
And I'm not stupid.
I don't do, like, Photoshop and shit. You must be stupid. Listen to yourself.
I would be stupid if I didn't stop and think about fucking shit and ask people to fucking prove shit to me. That is when I would wind up very fucking stupid, especially after the bullshit that I had been through. I would be very fucking stupid. And you would have very much of a fucking problem if you didn't fucking want to prove it to me.
Do you think that someone faking it would want to get you off? That would want to take your abuse
this? You see all the fucking things on the internet that has been about me? You see all them fucking things? Isn't that a fucking miracle how somebody would want to fuck with me, huh? Isn't that fucked up?
I don't look at all your stuff.
Yeah? Well.
Yeah, well.
Can't me believe you're you? Send me a video. You shouldn't have a problem. You know the fucked up situation I'm in. You've known it all along.
You know the fucked up situation.
You should have no fucking problem. I'm fucking surprised as hell that no new pictures of me have come up on the internet from the pictures that I've seen you.
Right, because I'm not putting them up there.
That is the one thing that has kept me hanging on to, okay, this girl has not been lying to me. Shit about her has been real.
The one thing that you've been hanging on to
is
because you're a desperate fuck that nobody will ever want. No one wants you. That's why you're hanging on to me. No one.
No, really.
Really? Believe me.
There are plenty of other girls that want me. I don't have a fucking problem with that.
Nobody wants a pedo sex offender. No one.
Well, you seem to want him, don't you?
No. When did I say that I wanted him?
You wanted him to come visit you? Is that so you could see his fucking cock?
What have I been telling you this whole time?
You brought it up, Casey!
I said it to fuck with you.
You fucking told this shit!
And it's funny. Loser.
You're laughing really hard, just like I'm laughing really hard.
You're not laughing.
You want this fucking drama-ass bullshit. You want this fucking drama-ass bullshit.
You're hanging on because nobody wants you. I'm not kidding you. I'm being very honest.
I'm hanging on because nobody wants me.
Yeah. That's why you hung on to Ramona.
Elizabeth seems to want me, doesn't she?
She said no. And she's just another internet person. How about somebody who's real, there? You can't get anybody, Lorne.
Who's here?
Everybody knows about
you. There's plenty of women here, though. There's plenty of women here that want me, Casey.
No,
I don't cheat on people. I'm honest with people.
There hasn't ever been anyone. You've been living there for 10 years and no one has ever wanted you. Yeah, really.
I'm just going to let you keep talking.
Okay.
Go ahead.
So a minute ago, you said you weren't interested in Elizabeth. You've never met her face to face. She's put you on
the internet. You're not trying to fucking turn shit around on me, Casey. Why don't you start being honest about yourself?
I am being honest with myself. Good. Change the subject.
You're not being honest.
Okay. How about if we call Ramona and see if she wants you? You want me to call her?
Oh, I would love it. Okay. I would really love it, because that would bring a lot of truth.
Hang on a second.
So, this could create a problem for people.
Hang on just a second.
As long as you have that in your mind, this could create a problem for a lot of people. Oh, Ramona's phone number.
I'm calling Emma, fucker.
Oh, you're calling Emma. Why not call Ramona? You got her phone number.
No, I don't.
You don't have a phone number. I've got it. I can give it to you.
Hello?
Hello?
Sorry, I hung up on you by accident. Christ.
Okay, well, let me ask you something. I just called your number back.
Mm-hmm.
And when the voicemail came on...
Mm-hmm.
It came up Emma's voicemail. That is not the first time that has done it.
You must not have called me then.
That's probably about the sixth or seventh time that it has done it.
Then you're not calling me.
I have double checked every fucking time. I have double checked and looked to make sure that I was calling your number.
Well, obviously you're not.
And it was your name on there
with your phone. I don't know what kind of shitty phone you're
on. Okay, then you tell me this. Why is it when I call your number, Emma's voicemail comes up?
I'm not with you,
Why is it that my mother's voicemail doesn't come up?
I don't know.
Why is that fucking little odd about this shit?
No, I find it odd that you don't know how to use a phone, obviously.
Really?
My voicemail is my
voicemail,
and it goes to my number.
When I press your number, and your name is on there, Emma's voicemail should not be coming up.
You're right, because you're obviously picking the wrong thing.
When it says your name, when I press the button, it should be your voicemail.
I can't see your phone. I know that my number goes to my voicemail.
you find some fucking weird shit going on here, Casey.
Well, what is it saying? Hi, this is Emma? I mean, what? Go ahead and call.
Call Elizabeth. Because you got all kinds of fucking weird shit going on in the last few days.
Well, I'm really not interested in continuing if this is how you're going to be, honestly.
I'm trying to make sure you're being honest with me.
Are you going to calm your
brain? You're the one that's got shit all over the place. After your phone call with Dan.
Yeah.
Are you fucking kidding me?
Are you going to call and have phone sex with Elizabeth? That would be so hot. Hang on, I'm going to call her.
If you fucking keep that bullshit up, you're going to lose me fucking fast. And I won't give a fuck. Because I don't think your bullshit is hot that you fucking did with Dan.
Hello?
I think it's pretty fucking disgusting.
Hey. Hey, it's Casey.
Oh, how'd you get my number? Not that I mind you having it, but
Lauren actually gave it to me.
Gave it to me.
Yeah.
Oh, okay, that's fine.
He's actually on the line, and he's pissed off, of course. Yeah, I don't know if he's like that with you, but he is with me. And he wanted me to call you, so I'm really not sure. So go ahead, Lauren.
Hi, Lauren. What's up? Lauren?
He's there. He's probably jerking off or something. Anyways, I'm not really sure what is supposed to be happening here, but I'll talk to you.
How's your relationship going with him?
It's pathetic.
What?
He fucking yells at me. He yells at me all the time.
What?
All the time. Yeah. Yeah, it's really bad.
I mean, he did used to yell at me a lot, but that was only when he was drinking. And, you know, and I understood that, like, you know, when he would get drunk that, you know, that would happen. But other than that, he was great. I mean, you know, when he wasn't drinking, he was fine.
Did he ever have phone sex with you?
No, we never did that.
Is it because of the erectile dysfunction?
He has that?
He has to.
To what?
I'm here.
I'm not listening.
Well, why weren't you talking? I introduced you, said that you were there.
I don't need to. I wonder what the conversation is going to be.
You said you wanted me to call her.
Okay, well, why don't you explain Dan?
Explain Dan?
Who's Dan?
Explain him.
Dan is Emma's boyfriend.
Oh.
So I don't know why he's having me tell you that.
But why does Emma's boyfriend need explaining?
I don't know.
don't say anything yet. Elizabeth?
Yeah?
Do you have your phone on record?
No, Lorne. Did you call me to find out if I had my phone on record? I have no way of recording you. I never have. What's up, Lauren? What's going on?
Don't say anything, Casey.
Okay.
So we're just all going to be quiet?
I guess.
I heard the recordings from 1:14:18 and 1:16:18.
What?
So because of that, I'm not going to say anything, and I don't want Casey to say anything either.
So then why did you call me?
I guess to tell you that Emma has a boyfriend named Dan.
So it's midnight, and you guys called me to tell me that somebody...
We told you. We got to tell you happy Memorial Day. King. Hey, after this, we call him and tell him happy Memorial Day now.
Okay.
Is this really... Wait a minute. Is this really what I was calling for?
Happy Memorial Day. We're thinking
Lauren
about you.
Something. I don't know what the problem is. I'm so sorry for bothering you.
Okay.
But I think that you should stay on the phone because we're here. Unless you have somewhere to be.
Well, it's 1:45 and I don't have anything planned, but, okay. I mean, you know, if you got, like, well, I don't know. I mean, what worked for me was just reassuring Lorne that I care about him. If he's yelling at you, you know, you might have to just reassure him that, you know, you might just have to reassure him that you care about him. That might be what you have to do.
He's been hurting me a lot lately, and it just makes me not want to reassure him, you know? Okay.
He hung up.
And then that was that. Hello?
Hello?
What the fuck, Lorne?
It took you so long to say hello.
I was saying hello, and then all of a sudden you come on like you're on a freaking megaphone.
I said hello 5 times.
Well, I didn't hear you 5 times. I heard you the 1 time. Anyways, what was that about? That was embarrassing.
Hang on a second. Somebody send me a message. I want to see who it is. Hang on.
Okay.
Dan's not very happy.
Okay.
I have Dan's number now. I don't know what the fuck you guys' issue was with giving me Dan's number was. But that's fucked up bullshit.
I'm not giving other people's numbers.
For one.
Not like you.
For one, it was fucked up that Dan wouldn't give me his phone number.
He just did. He told me he texted you.
Why are you sending me a message saying fuck you?
Because I want you to go fuck off.
Why, you don't want me? You want Dan? Who do you want, Casey?
Who
fuck
do
your
you
stupid
want,
fucking game.
Lorne?
I'm getting sick of it. I'm getting sick of it.
I am too.
I'm getting sick of the I'm fucking of drama. It. I'm getting sick of the fucking drama.
No, you're not.
Emma's getting sick of the drama, too.
No, she isn't. She loves me.
Yeah, well, I love you, too, but guess what?
What?
The drama bullshit, the calling other people's fucking boyfriend and having phone sex with them when your boyfriend is on the fucking phone.
You should have stopped me.
That's fucking bullshit.
Why did you sit there? Were you jerking off?
Why? Because I want to see how fucking far you were going to go.
I was going to go all the way.
Yeah, it was. Yeah, of course you were.
Yeah.
So you can have fucking phone sex with anybody. It doesn't have to be me.
You weren't going to stop.
So how many?
You should have stopped me.
How many people have you done that with? Since you've been with me, how many people have you fucking done that with? How important am I to you, Casey? How much do I mean to you?
I have told you before that I was talking to Dan.
How many times have you fucking cheated on me?
Shut your fucking mouth.
Shut your fucking mouth. How many times have you cheated on me?
And we're not cheating on each other. We're not together.
You know? You keep fucking saying that.
Right.
We're not even going to be fucking talking.
And you keep saying.
You keep saying
we're
that.
We're together.
We will not even be fucking talking if you keep saying that.
Yes, we will. You're not going anywhere.
You probably ought to get a. You ought to get a fucking grip on the power of your fucking mouth, because you're fucking
spoiled
that fucking brat that has always gotten what she wanted. But guess what? You're in the fucking real world dealing with real people that actually have feelings and are not on drugs.
Yeah.
Get a fucking grip, Casey. You're not talking to someone that's going to kiss your ass.
No, you'll kiss my ass. You will.
Only if you're going to fucking prove to me. Only if you're going to prove to me that you love me and I'm going to fucking cheat on me.
Because if I stopped talking to you, you'd be crying.
Because you're an actress?
You'd be crying.
Because you're an actress? Do you really think I give a fuck about that? I'm a fucking country boy.
When did I say
anything about that? I don't give a fuck what you are as long as you're loyal to me.
When did I say anything about that? You're so random.
Well, I'm trying to make sure you got it through your fucking head. I'm not somebody that you're going to just fuck with and me fucking be okay with it just because you're an actress. Because that don't fucking faze me at all.
I never said anything
about that. The fucking bullshit that you've been pulling? The fuck of it is, now I'm going to fucking question all the fucking truth. Are you really going to see me? Is it all just a fucking game? Again?
Yeah.
So you really plan to come out and see me?
Yeah, when I'm done with this.
When, Casey?
When I'm done with
this. When you're done with rehab.
Right.
Really?
Because that's priority.
You're going to come home with fucking Emma.
Yeah, as long as I'm done, yeah, then.
But how many guys are you going to call in the process and have phone sex with before you
however
come
however many I want. However many I want.
Yeah, well, you keep fucking doing that and you won't be coming out and see me.
Okay, good. I don't have to worry about being in a roast-infested shack.
I'm not going to be with somebody that's going to fucking dick around on me.
If you've been thinking that I'm dicking around this whole time, you're still here.
Yeah, well, I'm praying to God that you're fucking being a real woman. I'm praying to God that you're changing. I thought that I've seen you changing. I thought I'd missed things because you've been on my ass about things. Emma's fucking talked to me. Keep doing what you're doing, and all you can do is convince me that you might be part of the fucking perverted justice and the fucking cod bullshit.
Who cares about cod? Who the fuck cares?
Because I'm a fucking sensitive fucking way right now. There's a whole lot about that fucking cod bullshit that is just fucked right up. And where did you fucking meet me? On my YouTube channel.
Right. Yeah,
stop and think about that.
I wasn't through the Church of Cod. Whatever that, I mean, I wouldn't even know how to get there.
Yeah, well, what have you been doing the whole time that we've been together?
We're not together.
How many times have you cheated? How many times have you cheated on me?
There's no cheating if we're not together, you fucking idiot. Really?
We were together before, you fucking idiot. When you were in your rehab the first time, you fucking idiot.
And I told you.
Well, you seem to like to be talking over me.
Yeah.
I'll continue talking so you can't hear the words that I'm saying.
Because your words are bullshit.
So let me repeat myself again.
Okay.
You remember the first fucking place that you were at when you went out to fucking have lunch with someone?
Mm-hmm.
And when he was right at your phone and he was asking you to bend over. Do you remember that, Casey? Because I remember it very, very well.
I sort of do.
And you and I were supposed to be together then.
And what did I do?
Do you remember that, Casey? That was for cigarettes. You was on the phone with me. Why did I leave? I didn't go anywhere. I was on the phone.
You?
That's why he was in person.
Why didn't
he? He was in fucking person. Don't fucking turn shit around on me.
I'm asking you why you didn't.
On me.
Why didn't you leave?
You had a different fucking guy when you were supposed to be with me. You had a different fucking guy ready to stick his cock in you.
Mm-hmm.
When all you need to do is turn around and knock him the fuck out. Say, I'm sorry. I've got a boyfriend. Leave me the fuck alone.
Well,
why
we're
didn't
not
you stick up for yourself?
So there is no boyfriend.
Done it a few times over, Casey.
Why don't you have some fucking dignity and walk away from someone
when is
who
gonna
says
stop?
Cheating on you?
When is he going to stop, Casey?
Stop what?
When is fucking sex with other guys going to stop?
I'm not having sex with other guys.
Great, what did you just try to do with them?
And I'm not having sex with you either because you're not here.
Yeah, well,
so,
you're not here. Don't blame it on me. Don't blame it on me.
I'm in rehab, you fucker. I'm getting better, you fucker.
Yeah.
You're on probation, you fucker. You can't go anywhere,
yeah.
You fucker.
Emma is yours and my best friend, you fucker. What'd you just try to do with her boyfriend, you fucker? When you have a boyfriend, you fucker. With your boyfriend on the phone, how fucking great does that make you feel?
You're not my boyfriend, you fucking shithead. You're not my boyfriend. Hello? Where's my honey bunny? Hello?
Hello?
Yes?
Yeah, you called me back. What? You want me on the phone so you can have phone sex with someone else and me here?
No. We didn't do that.
Well, why not? You showed me you didn't have any problem the first time.
Would you like it? You liked it when I was fucking Emma.
Casey, you didn't get over your fucking sick-ass bullshit.
Get off your sick-ass bullshit, and I will, too.
Really? What sick-ass bullshit? You tell me what sick-ass bullshit I have.
Then
I'm the one, the girl from the fucking... the what?
You're crazy and obsessive.
Crazy and obsessive with what?
With me.
Really?
You're trying to own me instead of me just being myself and alive.
I'm trying to own you.
You're trying to.
You're going to use me as an excuse for you wanting to have sex, phone sex, with your best friend, with your boyfriend on the phone. Are you fucking serious?
No.
I would hope not. That's obviously a fucking lie and a half. And probably more than just a lie and a half.
What, like 2 times?
I'd probably about fucking 10 times. I don't understand that fucking bullshit.
Of course you don't. You don't understand anything.
I want an honest woman that's going to be honest with me. I don't want somebody that's going to fuck with me. I don't want somebody that's going to lie to me. I don't want somebody that's going to try and make me jealous all the fucking time.
I don't have to try. You do it on your own. You make up shit on
your
own.
Do I?
Yeah.
Do I?
Yes.
So you try to have fucking phone sex with Emma's boyfriend with me on the phone.
Yeah.
That's me trying to make you make me jealous.
No, you're not making me want to make you jealous.
You're making up fucking excuses.
Are you going somewhere?
You're trying to blame me for shit.
Are you trying to
blame me for every fucking thing that you're doing. Why are you doing that?
For the things that you do.
I tell you to fucking invite him to see you? Why, even if I told you to invite him to see you, why the fuck would you agree to something like that?
He never came to see me. Because I know the reaction that you're going to have. And it's funny. Because you're fucking crazy. You're a psycho.
No. Oh, yeah. Sure I am.
You are.
I'm the number one fucking chasing down Emma with a fucking knife and a gun. Are you serious?
Are you in a car right now?
I am. I'm going to give me a pack of cigarettes.
Oh.
I was going to quit that smoking after the last pack of cigarettes, but after the fucking bullshit you pulled, fuck that. She doesn't want to be serious, so I'm going to be fucking serious, and I'm going to go and give me a pack of fucking cigarettes again.
Oh, that makes perfect sense.
I'm only in one pack of cigarettes, so I'll smoke this pack of cigarettes, and if you fucking decide tomorrow you want to start being fucking serious, I'll stop smoking.
I don't give a shit if you stop smoking or not. What the fuck do I care? That's your problem.
You obviously do, because you fucking were certainly on my ass on the last night.
I thought you wanted to be a singer.
Yep. Doesn't matter. Doesn't matter what I fucking want.
It should. If that's what you wanted to do, and if smoking is what's holding you back from this being this world-known country singer, then why would you smoke?
I can't sing, remember?
Right, I know that, but you don't know that.
Oh, no, I know what I can do. But you said I can't sing.
Right, you can't. You fucking suck.
So why would I even want to try it? My girlfriend don't believe in me.
I'm not your girlfriend. I'm your friend. Who's you're trying to force into being your girlfriend.
Okay, she's not fucking... Stop fucking lying. Stop pulling that fucking girl out of that friend bullshit.
This is why.
If you keep fucking doing that, I'm just going to give up.
Okay, give up then.
I'm just going to fucking move on.
Okay, bye.